Hi everyone. In this video, let us discuss about fentanyl. What is this drug fentanyl? Fentanyl is one of the synthetic opioid analgesic. Among the opioids, morphine, codeine are few of the natural opioids derived from the opium plants. But fentanyl is a synthetic opioid agonist. And this drug chemically belongs to anilinopiperidines. A piperidine ring is attached to the aniline by fourth question. So, fentanyl is a synthetic opioid agonist belonging to anilinopiperidines. This structural modification from morphine to fentanyl results in increased potency. So, fentanyl is around 100 times more potent than morphine. That's why fentanyl shows high analgesic property compared with morphine at low dose. And this fentanyl can be used to control the breakthroughs of cancer pain in the patients along with other sedatives. And this drug is also used as adjunct to anesthesia. During the anesthesia, pain transmission should be inhibited. So fentanyl can be used along with the IV anesthetics in order to reduce the pain transmission. And it can also be combined with few of the other drugs such as droperidol, which is a neuroleptic, which reduces the agitation and induce the sedation. So fentanyl in combination with droperidol produces neuroleptic analgesia. Today in this video we are going to see how this fentanyl acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, different dosage forms and its chemical nature. All these things we will discuss in this video. Now let us the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of fentanyl. Here we can clearly observe anilinopiperidine ring system. Now if we write the IUPAC name of this drug, we have to consider the amide as the principal functional group. So this is 1, 2, 3. So simply it is a propanamide derivative. Now to this propanamide, on the nitrogen, one phenyl ring is present and piperidine ring is present. So we can write this as N phenyl and then N dash. This piperidine ring can be given numbering such that first number should be given to the nitrogen, so this is 1 and this is 4. So piperidine ring is attached by fourth position, which can be written as piperidine 4-ol. Now to this piperidine ring, phenyl ethyl chain is present. So 1-phenyl ethyl, that is the complete name of fentanyl. Now let us see how this drug acts. When the pain is going to be generated at the periphery, it gives nociceptive stimuli, which is going to be carried by few of the sensory neurons. These nociceptive neurons can send the signal to the spinal cord, which acts as gating mechanism, which can control this pain sensation. Otherwise, it can send the signals to the brain so that the higher centers within the brain can perceive the pain sensation. Otherwise, they can also send few of the mediators, which can control the pain at the spinal cord. In this way, spinal cord acts as a gating mechanism for nociceptive pathways. And then the signals are sent from the spinal cord to the brain, where at the higher centers, this pain is going to be perceived. Now, opioids can control the pain at the brain, spinal cord, as well as at the periphery. So, within the brain, the mu opioid receptors are located, which are G protein coupled receptors. Similarly, at the spinal cord, the kappa receptors are present. And at the periphery, delta receptors are present. All these opioid receptors are G protein coupled receptors. Now fentanyl acts as opioid agonist. It can activate the mu receptors within the brain as well as it can activate the delta receptors within the periphery. And it also shows agonist activity on the kappa receptors at the spinal cord level. But this drug fentanyl is having the more affinity towards the mu receptors, resulting in the high analgesia as well as high euphoria compared with other opioids. This is the presynaptic neuron which is going to store the excitatory neurotransmitter such as glutamate, and this is a postsynaptic neuron equipped with glutamate receptors such as AMPA receptors as well as NMDA receptors. Now these AMPA receptors are inotropic receptors. They are coupled with sodium channels. Normally by exocytosis this glutamate can be released and it can act on the AMPA receptors, which activates the sodium channel so that sodium can enter to produce excitatory postsynaptic potential. In this way, glutamate acts as excitatory neurotransmitter, which can increase the nociception by increasing the excitation of nociceptive neurons. Not only the glutamate, so many other mediators are responsible for this nociception. For instance, substance P can also increase the pain transmission. Now, these presynaptic neurons are equipped with opioid receptors such as mu receptors within the brain, kappa receptors within the spinal cord, delta receptors within the periphery. Now, fentanyl acts as mu receptor agonist. It can bind to these mu receptors, which are coupled with adenyl cyclase system. By activation of these receptors, adenyl cyclase is inactivated, such that ATP is somewhat less converted into cyclic AMP. So, cyclic AMP levels are reduced, which results in the decreased entry of calcium through the voltage-gated calcium channels. Now, calcium cannot enter into the presynaptic neurons, which results in the decreased exocytosis. At the same time, fentanyl can open the potassium channels, so potassium can go outside, resulting in the hyperpolarization and inhibition of neurons. So, within the presynaptic neurons, the neurotransmitter is not released. Similarly, if you have the mu, opioid receptors are also present on postsynaptic neurons. Now, fentanyl can act on these receptors to produce inhibition of postsynaptic neurons. In this way, fentanyl acts as opioid agonist, thereby can control the nociception at all these three levels, at the central level within the brain, as well as spinal cord, as well as at the periphery. But this drug is having the more affinity towards the mu opioid receptors. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of fentanyl is that this drug can produce some respiratory depression. Because of this, it can produce some bronchospasm, which may result in the accumulation of carbon dioxide, leading to increased carbon dioxide levels within the serum. So, in the patients with any asthma and respiratory disorders, this fentanyl should be carefully given because it produces some severe respiratory depression. And when this drug is combined with other drugs such as chlorpromazine, which is an antipsychotic, pancuronium, which is a skeletal muscle relaxant, and benzodiazepines, barbiturates, all these are the CNS depressants which may produce some respiratory depression. Similarly, alcohol can also produce CNS depression. So, these drugs and alcohol, when they are combined with fentanyl, they can increase the respiratory depression. So, again, care should be taken when this fentanyl is combined with other CNS depressants. Similarly, this fentanyl should be carefully given in the patients with COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder, where we can observe some irreversible bronchospasm due to the damage of bronchioles. So, fentanyl should be carefully given in the patients with COPD. Similarly, this drug can increase the sedation just like other opioids. So, it can produce some drowsiness, dizziness, some confusion. As well as this drug can also increase the euphoria, which results in some addiction. Again, this precaution should be considered when this drug is combined with alcohol, otherwise with other CNS depressants, because all these drugs can increase the sedation as well as drowsiness in the patients. That's why whenever this fentanyl is prescribed, the patient should take some precaution while driving the vehicles or working with machinery, because it produces some sedation as well as drowsiness within the patients. As we have discussed, fentanyl can produce respiratory depression so that it can increase the carbon dioxide levels within the serum. And when these carbon dioxide levels are excessively increased, they can increase the intracranial pressure. This is more significant in the patients with any head injury or trauma, where the raised intracranial pressure may increase the hemorrhage within the patients. So, fentanyl should be carefully given in the patients with any head injury or recent trauma. Fentanyl is going to be converted into metabolites by CYP3A4 enzyme. So many drugs such as ritonavir, ketoconazole, itraconazole, erythromycin, clarithromycin, verapamil, all these drugs are the inhibitors of CYP3A4 enzyme. So when this enzyme is inhibited, fentanyl levels are increased, resulting in the increased respiratory depression as well as sedation within the patients. What are the side effects? The important side effects of fentanyl mainly include symptoms related with CNS depression. It can produce some sedation, drowsiness, dizziness, and it can also produce vasodilation resulting in hypotension. Patient may observe some dry mouth. And because of decreased GI motility, it can produce some constipation and it can stimulate the CTZ, resulting in the nausea and vomiting. It can produce respiratory depression, resulting in dyspnea, difficulty in breathing. It can increase the release of histamine, resulting in pruritus, and other side effects such as sweating, insomnia and confusion can be observed with this fentanyl. How it is given? This drug is available as different dosage forms. It is available as tablets, which are given either by sublingual route or buccal route. In order to avoid the first pass metabolism, fentanyl can be given either by sublingual or buccal route. And it's also available as transdermal patches, IV solution, and even lozenges. And the dose of the drug depends on the type of dosage form. For instance, as a lozenges, it can be initiated at 200 microgram. But the dose should be always titrated based on the patient conditions and it should be individualized. So that's about this drug, fentanyl, which is a opioid agonist, which is highly potent than morphine. So it produces higher analgesia. But along with analgesia, this drug can also increase the euphoria as well as sedation within the patients. Because of euphoria, this fentanyl can produce some drug addiction, which may lead to some dependence and withdrawal effects. Sedation, drowsiness, dizziness, and respiratory depression are the important side effects of this drug. And just like the other opioids, this drug can also produce some constipation, blurred vision, dry mouth, nausea and vomiting, which are associated with activation of opioid receptors. So that's about this drug, fentanyl. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.